you can keep improving at home on your own after brain injury, stroke, and with Parkinson's disease. There are a lot of activities you can engage in and exercises you can do, of course. A lot of those can be related to music. I've been doing a lot of reading that says that rhythmic exercises in particular can be beneficial in this endeavor. So I have a rhythm exercise that I've sort of played around with, and I want to share it with you today. I'm going to demonstrate it, and I hope you will join me. What I'm going to do is I'm going to use this little ribbon wand here. So I hope you'll stay with me for that. This is just a little piece of ribbon attached to a stick, of course. Now, I am not a handy person with a glue gun or anything, so I bought a little stash of these, and I have some extra. So when this video is over, if you want to go over to my website, I will send you one. The reason that I like to use something like this is, as I tell my survivors in my online classes, is that it's kind of good to be able to touch the beat. There's a little imaginary beat in front of you when the music is playing and you're being asked to do something along with the beat. If you just touch the beat, so you can use a stick if you don't have one of these guys, or a pen, or a pencil, or a spatula, or a stick from the yard, whatever. Doesn't really matter. You could use your finger, but it's not as much fun. So I encourage you to grab something. But if you just touch the beat, sort of gets you kinesthetically involved, and it helps engage your mind and keep your focus on the task at hand. So I think it's helpful. We're going to do this exercise if you stick with me. And I also have a free printable that goes along with this that you can do extended and different practice at home on your own. It's linked in the description below. Also linked in the description below is the particular study, the case report, that I am pulling this inspiration from. And there are a couple of things that are very worth our time pointing out that are little elements that I've included in this exercise based on this study. And it's important that we take a peek at it. So we're going to do that briefly before we do this. So stay with me. The study that I'm looking at right at this moment for this exercise is from the Journal of Bodywork and Movement Therapies, and it was done by physical therapists. And what they did was they were working with a traumatic brain injury survivor. They did some tests with her, tested some cognition and some movement things, and they taught her a specific set of musical exercises to do at home on her own, and then they retested her. And guess what? They saw marked improvement in some really good areas. All areas are good, but it's very, very exciting what they did find, and the particular reasons and elements of things they included are useful to us. And here's what they are. Auditory cues. All those are it's an external beat that is going on that you can hang your exercise on. So a metronome beat, I'm about to play a metronome. It's probably going to upset my golden retrievers. It did. Can you hear that? That's just a steady beat going on in the background, something that you can put your rhythm exercise to. And we'll do that. I think it's a lot more fun to pick out a piece of music that you like that makes you feel good, still has that same steady beat that you can adhere to and build your rhythmic exercise on. Another thing that is an important element in this exercise we're about to do is something called crossing the midline. I've heard this before, but I looked it up to be sure. And a midline, the midline is just a divider. This way on your body, it divides one half of your body from the other half. And when you cross the midline, all you're doing is you're taking a hand from one side and you're crossing and putting it on the other side. So now I'm crossing the midline and now I'm not. Now I'm crossing the midline, now I'm not. Could be with a hand, a foot, a leg, any part of you that's crossing over to the other side of you. It's crossing the midline, and that has specifically good implications. I read in a variety of places now for cognition and other good things after brain injury and stroke and with Parkinson's disease too. All right, this is the coolest part of this. these are the things, and you can read the whole abstract. It's short, actually. I've linked it in the description below. I just want to pull out the most exciting things that they found. They were able to prove, see an improvement in her movement and her gait after these exercises. Also, she had some improved and new sensation in her hand and some of her fingers and in a leg after this exercise. And also cognitive improvement. They gave her an IQ test before the exercises, and they gave her one after the exercises, and guess what? The score went up. I mean, that is pretty thrilling to me. Hopefully it is to you too. All right, so we're going to do this thing. We're going to be crossing the midline, and it's going to have a, we're going to have an auditory cue. Now, we are going to do with the metronome a little bit, because that's what the researchers say is a useful thing. We're also going to put with music. All right, so it's pretty simple. I'm going to try to make it entertaining for me and for you. I'm going to take my little handy stick here, and I'm just going to go from, I'm going to cross my body to one side, then I'll go back. Then I'll cross it and go back. I'm going side to side, side to side, 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 side. We're going to do it with the metronome. Now, also, if you want to change it up a little, do that with me. You can cross diagonally and go up. You can go up across your face and back down to this hip, to that shoulder, and this hip. Up and down, up and down. We're going to go side to side, up and down, side to side. Stick with me. We'll do music in a minute. I'm going to really try to flick this so you can see it, and I'll tell you as I'm doing it. I'm going side to side first. Here we go. Side, side, do two. Side, 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 side. I'm going to do a little faster. Side, 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 side. Side, 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 side. Now we're gonna go up, up and down, and up and down, and up and down. Now I'm going to do it faster. Up, down, up, down. Down, up, down, up, down, up, down. Then I'm gonna go to the side again. Go side, 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 side. Then we're gonna go up and down again. Go up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down. So let's listen, let's try it with the ukulele, and I'll, you know, hopefully you'll find it engaging. Can you feel that beat? We should just feel it first. You could tap your foot to the beat. All right, we're gonna go side to side again. We'll do that slower part. Here we go. Side. Side, 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 side. We're going up next. Here, down, up, down, up, and down, up, and down, up, and down. Let's go back to the side. Side, 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 side. Let's go up and down now. Here we go. Up, down, up, down, up, down, up, down, and side. Last time up and down. Here we go. Up and down, both sides. Side. And up. Up. Down, both sides. And up. And down. Side. Side. Can we do all that faster? We're going to on this next one. Here we go. Up. Down, side, side. Up, down, side, side. Up, down, side, side. Up, down, side, side. So if you can find a piece of music that you like that's not too fast and not too slow, with a little stick or something to touch the beat, then you can do a rhythmic exercise with an auditory cue and cross the midline. And you can see those researchers found it to be beneficial. So it's worth taking some time to do at home. And if you can combine it with a piece of music that you like, then it'll improve your mood at the same time. I have a free printable exercise that is on my website, and you can go over and download it. Go to beyondhighc.com/study-session-2. In the description box below this video. So, got a couple of links down there. Check out those links. Please subscribe to the channel and please give this video a like if you found it helpful. Thank you for watching, and we hope to see you next time.